everyone, welcome to a new video of IPO analysis. Today we will be reviewing the IPO of Ami Organics Limited. We'll start with the company's background, then we'll talk about the key highlights, financial performance, issue details, objectives of the IPO, and in the end our recommendation. I'm fundamental research analyst Siddhi Acharya, and I welcome you all to our YouTube channel Choice. Ami Organics is a specialty chemical manufacturing company. It focuses on manufacturing pharma intermediates for regulated and generic APIs and new chemical entities. As per the RHP, the company is the major manufacturer pharma intermediates for certain APIs which have their application in certain high-growth therapeutic areas like anti-inflammatory, antipsychotic, anti-cancer, etc. They also manufacture key starting materials for agrochemical and fine chemicals. The company has diversified its product portfolio by acquiring two manufacturing facilities of Gujarat Organics, which manufactures added preservatives and other specialty chemicals. Ami Organics has developed over 450 pharma intermediates for APIs, which contributed around 88% of the total revenue of the company in FY21. Specialty chemical segment contributed 4.9% of the total revenue in FY21. They supply their products to over 150 customers globally, and their exports contribute 52% of the total revenue. Italy, Finland, France, and China are the top contributors to the export revenue. The company's domestic client list includes companies like Lauris Labs, Cadila Healthcare, Cipla Limited, amongst others. On the back of higher demand for its products, the company's revenue grew by 19.5% CAGR over the years FY19 to FY21 and stood at 340 crores in FY21. The operating expenditure increased by 15.1% CAGR, which was lower than the top line growth. This led to a 38% CAGR rise in consolidated EBITDA. Reported PAT increased by 52% CAGR and stood at 54 crores in FY21. They reported positive cash flow from operating activities, which increased by 35% CAGR during the period. Consolidated financial liabilities increased by 55.9% CAGR. However, the debt-to-equity ratio remained at 0.8x in FY21 as compared to 0.7x in FY19. The company has priced its IPO at a price band of 603 rupees to 610 rupees. There will be 24 shares in one lot, and at the higher price band, the total application money is 14,640 rupees. The IPO opens on 1st September and closes on 3rd September. The company is planning to raise 570 crores through this IPO. Out of this, 200 crores will be through fresh issue and 370 crores will be through offer for sale. The company will not receive any amount from offer for sale, and of the net proceeds from the fresh issue, 140 crores will be used for repaying the debt, 90 crores will be used for funding the working capital of the company, and the remaining amount will be used for general corporate purpose. As of 31st March 2021, the company acquired two manufacturing plants of Gujarat Organics. FY21 financial statements of Ami Organics does not include the impact of this acquired business. With asset turnover of around 3.5x for Gujarat Organics assets, the consolidated revenue for Ami Organics will be higher in FY22 and FY23. However, the operating margins of this acquired business is far lower than the existing business of Ami Organics. Thus, on a consolidated basis, the profitability of Ami Organics will be lower than what was reported over FY19 to FY21. Additionally, significant improvement in FY21 profitability is one-off and thus is not sustainable. So overall, we are anticipating a strong business growth in the medium term, but with lower profitability. At the higher price band, Ami Organics is demanding a PE multiple of 41.2x, which is at a discount to the peer average. Anticipating lower profitability in the medium term, we feel that this issue is reasonably priced. considering the dominant market position of the company in the manufacture of pharma intermediates for certain high-growth therapeutic areas, business growth from specialty chemicals, and lower debt levels post-IPO, we would recommend our investors to subscribe to this issue. If you liked our video, please click on the like button and subscribe to our channel to never miss an update on the upcoming IPOs. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.